So from the stoichiometry, you have questions. You have questions. Only 2 marks for this exam. Only for 2 marks this exam. So that is significant figures and mole concept. Okay. So see the mole concept. See beta mole. Okay. See beta mole. M O L E. Mole is the SI unit of mass. Mole is the mass of unit in standard international methods. That is SI unit of mass. So remember, 1 mole of substance. Any one mole of substance is equal to gram molecular weight. Is equal to gram molecular weight of the substance. Okay, means the weight of one molecule in its gram, which is also known as molar mass. Okay, the mass of 1 mole is mass of 1 molecule is a molar mass. Okay, and every 1 mole of substance, it contains the Avogadro number of particles. So Avogadro number of particles means 6.023 × 10³. Okay, so if it is 1 mole of oxygen, 1 mole of oxygen, tell me how many oxygens are there? Avogadro number of oxygens. If 1 mole of N2 gas, 1 mole of N2 gas means Avogadro number of N2 molecules. Okay, 1 mole of electrons, 1 mole of electrons, then 6.023 × 10³ electrons, which is Avogadro number. And if it is, this substance is one is what, gas or liquid, then its volume at STP is taken as 22.4 liters. Then you can convert this liter into mls also. That is 1 liter equal to 1000 ml. So into 1000, therefore 22, then point here, decimal is there, into 1000, 22400 ml. Remember, the ml itself, milliliter itself, is centimeter cube, cc, it is equal to centimeter cube. Okay, centimeter cube, cc, 1 ml is a ml. Why? Because volume is what? Length into length. So centimeter into centimeter is a centimeter cube, cc, or milliliter. So this is what called as a mole concept. So here you have to do calculations. Have to do calculation based on the mole concept. And here see, for this the simple formula, okay, the simple technique is what? Crisscross method. The best is what? Crisscross method. Remember this one, what I have explained, 1 mole equal to gram molecular weight of the substance, that is molar mass, it is equal to Avogadro number of particles. If it is gas, it shows how much of volume at STP condition. Gram molar volume is called as 22.4 liters. In mls, that is 22400 ml. Then you may be having doubt, what is STP condition, madam? STP, or you can say NTP, both are same. Okay, that is normal temperature pressure or standard temperature pressure, where temperature is taken as 273 Kelvin, that is 0 degree Celsius, and pressure is taken as 1 atmosphere. Pressure taken as 1 atmosphere is also called as 1 bar also. 1 bar also. Okay. And this 1 atmosphere itself is 760 millimeters of height of mercury in barometer. Okay. So now I'm going to explain this. So these conditions are what? STP condition. At this condition, any 1 molecule substance whose mass is 1 gram molecular weight, will occupy the gram molar volume or say molar volume, and its value is 22.4 liters. So based on this, we have to do calculations. This is called mole concept. It is proposed by Lavoisier. Okay, and which made the calculations easy even in the industrials. Okay, so therefore, the Lavoisier is called as father of modern chemistry. Okay, so see here. Now, please tell me better, what is the formula of glucose? What is the formula of glucose? Glucose. Okay, glucose. Now, normally it is known as sugar. Okay, normally it is known as sugar. Glucose formula beta. Glucose formula is C. Glucose C6H12O6. Very good, Sai. Very good, Vamshi Krishna. Okay, glucose formula is C6H12O6. Very good. Okay, now it's a molecule. It's a molecule and its weight. Its weight is called as molecular weight. Weight of a molecule called molecular weight. So like we are person, okay, we are human body, we have a weight that is called body weight, not head weight, that is called a body weight. So our total body weight is what? Sum of weight of our head, then these limbs, hands and what is legs and your trunk. Means in the same way, the molecular weight, okay, the weight of the molecule also is the sum, S-U-M sum of all the atoms weight in the given molecule. So this molecule contain how many carbons? 6 carbons. So take the 6 carbons weight, add with 12 hydrogens weight, then add with 6 oxygens weight, that is total weight of glucose molecule. So tell me, what is the molecular weight of this glucose? See here, 6 carbon, 6 into each one is 6 into each one is 12, okay, and plus 12 hydrogens, each one is 1, and next plus 6 oxygens, each one is 16. What do you get here? Tell me, what do you get here? Okay, do the 6 12s are. 6 12s are, I know it, 72 plus 12, then 16 6 are, 16 4s are 64, 16, okay, 16 4s are 64, 16 6 are, add 32, okay, this total weight will be equal to, so you have to do divide, and first means separate, then it is 180, what is that weight? The weight of this glucose will be what? 180 grams. And this is 180 grams per molecule. Okay? Per one molecule. Okay? And the one molecule is mole. Therefore, this weight is called as grams per mole. 180 grams per mole. Not 84. Do complete beta. Okay? Now, it's a question. The very first question. I hope this must come. Idu ravalsindi. Okay, ఇది రావాల్సిందే అనుకుంటున్నాను నేను ఉంటున్నారా I hope this must come. So here see, the question is like this. Okay, how many moles of glucose, how many moles of glucose in 540 grams of a sample. Ante ఒక sample ఇచ్చారు, ఆ sample లో ఎంత ఉంది weight of glucose? 540 grams ఉంది. So నువ్వేం find out చేయాలి, ఎన్ని moles నే find out చేయాలి. So see here, simple knowledge, what is that? One mole, okay. One mole equal to weight of one molecule, weight of a molecule. Is that clear? That is one mole equal to, so what is the weight of molecule in grams for glucose, it is 180 grams. It is 180 grams. Then x moles, okay, crisscross. Adigindi enni moles, how many moles? X moles to the 540 grams. 540 grams. So what do you do here? Crisscross. You have to do crisscross. So you get answer here is what? It is. See, that is 180x in is equals to 180x is equals to 540 into 1. Therefore, x is equals to 540. 540 by 540 by 180. That is 3. Means how many moles are there? 3 moles. So I hope this question should come tomorrow, definitely. Okay. 3 moles. 3 moles. Okay. And next, in the same way. In the same way. In the same way. Okay. In the same way. Please check the question which I have sent to you. The question which I sent to you. Okay. In the first question, see there. See there. Okay. First page of stoichiometry. The first question is. The next, calculate the weight of. Calculate the weight of 0.1 mole of sodium carbonate. Tell me, beta, what is the weight of sodium carbonate? What is the weight of sodium carbonate? What is the weight of sodium carbonate? Pillalu, cheppali. Yes, children. Tell, what is the weight of sodium carbonate? Or simple, the weight of sodium, what is the molecular formula of sodium carbonate first? It is known as soda ash. If it is washing soda, then 10H2O. I'm asking sodium carbonate. Sodium. Sound is sodium. Na. Carbonate. CO3. So CO3 minus 2. Na plus. Therefore. Okay. So see here. The question is asked. Here see. The question is weight. Okay. Weight of 0.1 mole. Of sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. Okay. So for this you have to solve. Okay. Give the answer. Give the answer. Give the answer. Direct answer. Okay. Give the answer by mole concept. So see here. Sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate. I'm writing in short. Sodium carbonate. Formula Na2CO3. Na2CO3, which is called as soda ash, not washing soda. Washing soda ante ikkada and water molecules undali. Okay na? Decahydrated Na2CO3. Sodium carbonate is called washing soda. It is soda ash. Okay. So Na2CO3. So here, 1 mole means 1 molecule. Then 1 mole equal to weight. Weight of 1 molecule. Weight of molecule. In grams. So what is that? 1 mole equal to, see, sodium, how many? 2 sodium. Each sodium is 23. Each sodium is 23 into 2. Okay, into 2. That is 46. That is 46. Next, carbon. 1 is there. 12 into 1. That is 12. Next, oxygens. 3 are there. In each one is 16, that is 3, 48, okay, 48. So tell me, what is this? 46 plus 12 plus 48, this is 106, it is 106 grams per mole. So ask for what it is, weight of 0.1 mole of sodium carbonate. So here, 0.1 mole is given and asking weight. So calculate x grams. Once again, simple. What is that? Crisscross. Crisscross. So what is that? You get here. So what is the answer, beta? Here, this is x is equals to, okay, x into 1 and 0.1 into 106. Therefore, what is that? 0.1 into 106. 106. So what happens here? By 1 it is, you can avoid that. So 1 decimal point increases. 1 decimal point increases. So what happens? This is This is 10.6. Okay. 10.6. Okay, na. And next. Next. Okay. We'll go for the significant figures, or we'll. Do you want to do one more problem? We'll do later after significant figures. So for that also, I send you the questions. What is to be done? Okay. What is to be done? Okay, now we'll see significant figures. Significance means we are giving what it is, identity, significance, importance to the certain figure. So here, what is this figure? Numerical digit. So we know that how many numerical digits are there? 10. That is 0, 0, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These 0 to 9 are called as numerical digits or numerical figures. Okay. So everyone knows that this 1 to 9, they have their definite value, fixed value. 1 means 1, 2 means 2, fixed value. Okay. So, to which digit or figure we are going to give a significance? What is that? 0. Because 1 ante 1 ne, 2 ante 2 ne, 9 ante 9 ne. No 9 ni, 9 rasi, 8 ani cheptava? Evaraina 9 rasi, 8 ani cheptara? Chepte em avutundi? Andaru navutaru manu chusi. 9 ante 9 ne. Okay? 9 apples. You have to give 9 apples. So, midi pettali. Okay? So, and 6 pettese 5 ante oppukuntara? Evidiko ema Indra Babu antaru. Okay na? So, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are having definite value, significant. Now, which is not having significance? 0. So, here in significant figures, we learn how to give significance to the 0. Okay. So, here the zeros are of three types. The zeros are of three types. Okay. The zeros are of three types. So, meeku pambiche question undi kada, aa question 34, 35 ante adi cheyali meeru. So, the 0, we are going to give the significance to this 0. Then remember, zeros of three types. The one is preceding 0. Okay? Means, they never be significant. Always non-significance. They don't have significance. Ever. Means they just indicate decimal point. So see here, example 0.02. 0.02. In this number, okay, this decimal is before the, sorry, this zero, okay, a decimal, before the decimal, zero is there. Now after the decimal, zero is there. Remember, these two zeros doesn't have any importance or significance. They just indicate. That is, this 2 is after decimal at second place. So, here, the zeros which are starting, which are at starting and which carry the decimal point, they just indicate the decimal position, but they are not significant. So, in this, which number is having significant? Only 1. So, what is that? 2 is significant. So, in this example, the number of significants are how many? 1. The next one is trapped. Trapped means a zero in between two non-zero and a 1 to 9 means 1 to 9. The 1 to 9 digits figures are significant, which are non-zero. Zero can't be. So if it is any zero, is in between two non-zeros, is always significant. The trapped is always significant. So, which is sandwiched, okay, like a stuff between the two breads always have significance. Because of stuff, we have taste of sandwich, burger, like that. So, it is trapped means burger, sandwiched, zero. It is trapped and always significance. So here see example 202. So in this what? So this zero is in between the two non-zero digits. The two is significant. This two also significant. Or you can take here five also. The two is also significant because two has definite value. Y has definite value. And in between these two, the zero is trapped. So this zero is a trap and this is having what? Significance. Remember, if any zero is having left side non-zero is significant. Okay. Is a significant. And right side decimal is also significant. Okay. So in this, all these are significant. So in this number, how many significant figures are there? Total three significant figures. Okay. Total three significant figures. Okay. And next. And next, here see, the next one is trailing, okay? Trailing, okay? The trailing zeros also significant, okay? Significant if they have a decimal at right side. So, which comes at ending and they will be significant. So, see the question which I sent to you. Okay. E question chudandi in this. Examples are given. You don't go for much because you are just writing IP. After that, we'll see later. As I have sent you so many examples for what is JEE exams. Now, don't go for that. So simple. So here, question number 34. Here, the first one is 0, okay, decimal. The first is 0.0025. 0025. So here, see, these three zeros are before the non-zero. Zero kante left side lo mundu non-zero vaste appudu zero ku significance undi. But this zero is having what? Non-zero at right side. Right side lo ante there is no significance to the zero. Always the zero must have non-zero at left side. Okay. So here these two zeros are non-significant and this two and five are significant. So in this two significant figures. Then next one, 208. Now what is this one? The first is leading. Always leading is non-significant. Here, now this zero is in between the two and eight. A trapped zero is always significant. So it is having 2 is significant, 0 is significant, 8 also significant. So totally 3 significant figures. And next. Okay, next. Third example. Same like that. 5005. So these two are trapped. So all are what? Significant. And this the letter. Okay. Next. What is that? Next. 126,00. For this, what is given there? What is given there? See here. 126,00. Now in this 1, 2, 3 are significant. 1, 2, 3 are significant. Okay. And what about these zeros? If these zeros have a decimal point at right side, then they can be significant. As they don't have decimal at right side, therefore they are not significant. Therefore only 3. And next is in this question only. Kanipinchat ledu. 500.0. Now in this, how many decimals are there? Please see beta. Okay, after decimal, how many places are there? One place. Okay, one place. So here see, these zeros are having the non-zero at left side. So whenever zero is having the left side, whenever zero is having the left side, non-zero is significant. Then this zero is having what? Not only decimal, the left side non-zero. Therefore, four significant figures. Four significant figures. Some typical ka ilage untai. And next, see here. Next one is 2.0034. So here, see. Now, here, 2 is significant, 3 is significant, 4 is significant. And this 0 is not only having decimal, a non-zero at left side. So these are significant. Total how many? 5 significant figures. So do this. And below, rounding numbers are there. Okay? So this much is only for, from stoichiometry. Okay, revise all. If you have any doubt, ask me. You can call me and ask me any doubt you have. All the best, ma. Now have a strong preparation.